Aerobic respiration occurs within cells. It starts with glycolysis in the cytosol of the cell. It then goes through the link reaction, moving into the matrix of the mitochondria. It then goes through the citric acid cycle within the mitochondria matrix. Then it goes through the electron transport chain and chemiosmosis in the inner mitochondrial membrane, producing energy in the form of ATP. In this video, we are going to look at the third process involved in aerobic respiration, the citric acid cycle, also known as the tricarboxylic acid cycle, or TCA cycle. It is also known as the Krebs cycle. At the end of glycolysis and the link reaction, we were left with two molecules of acetyl-CoA within the mitochondria matrix that can now enter the citric acid cycle. As we move through the citric acid cycle, we will take note of how many NADH, FADH2, and ATP are used or produced. There are eight steps in the citric acid cycle. The first step involves the joining of one of the two carbon acetyl-CoA molecules with the four carbon molecule oxaloacetate, forming the six carbon molecule citrate using the enzyme citrate synthase and a water molecule. Coenzyme A is also released. The second step involves the dehydration and then rehydration of citrate into isocitrate using the enzyme aconitase, where a water molecule is released and then a water molecule is added back on. The third step involves the decarboxylation and oxidation of isocitrate, a 6-carbon molecule, into alpha-ketoglutarate, a 5-carbon molecule, using the enzyme isocitrate dehydrogenase. This step involves a carbon dioxide molecule being removed. NAD+ is also reduced to NADH plus hydrogen. This gives us one NADH, giving us a net total so far of one NADH for one acetyl-CoA molecule. The fourth step involves the conversion of alpha-ketoglutarate, a 5-carbon molecule, into succinyl-CoA, a 4-carbon molecule, using the enzyme alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. This step involves the removal of a carbon dioxide molecule. A coenzyme A group is added, and NAD+ is reduced into NADH and hydrogen. This step creates another NADH, taking our net total to 2 NADH for one acetyl-CoA molecule. The fifth step involves the conversion of succinyl-CoA into succinate using the enzyme succinyl-CoA synthetase. In this step, the coenzyme A is removed. It also involves substrate-level phosphorylation of GDP and an inorganic phosphate into GTP. This GTP can then give a phosphate group to ADP to form ATP. This step produces an ATP, taking our net total so far to 2 NADH and 1 ATP for one acetyl-CoA molecule. The sixth step involves the oxidation of succinate into fumarate using the enzyme succinate dehydrogenase. This step involves the reduction of FAD into FADH2. This step produces an FADH2, taking our net total so far for one acetyl-CoA molecule to 2 NADH, 1 FADH2, and 1 ATP. The seventh step involves the hydration of fumarate into malate using the enzyme fumarase. This step involves the addition of a water molecule. The eighth and final step involves the oxidation of malate into oxaloacetate using the enzyme malate dehydrogenase. This step reduces NAD+ into NADH and hydrogen. This step produces an NADH, taking our net total for one acetyl-CoA molecule to 3 NADH, 1 FADH2, and 1 ATP. So far, we have had one acetyl-CoA go through the citric acid cycle, but we have two acetyl-CoA molecules per glucose molecule, so this cycle would go through twice. This doubles our net total for the citric acid cycle, giving us a final net total of 6 NADH, 2 FADH2, and 2 ATP.
Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe and hit that like button.